What is up, guys? My name is Jake. Man, has this been a strange week for me. I'm gonna excuse my no videos just because this week has been not only strange, but very, not tough, but very stressful and strange. It's just a lot of strangeness now. It's things change and only change. Who am I? My name's Jake. I already said this. This is going to be a lot of black screen again. Welcome to the fifth episode of Abandoned. You guys, oh my god, this is the most requested thing ever. Today we are doing Alcatraz Federal Penitentiary. Please keep your screams down to a minimum because I know everybody wanted this video. Like, so many people. That Nick Studios. We're going to get to Nick Studios at some point. Here's all the people that, wanted it, because it's a freaking hell of a lot of people. So, today we're going to be exploring the details of Alcatraz Federal Penitentiary, mostly known as Alcatraz. Alcatraz was a high-security maximum prison on Alcatraz Island, which is about 2 kilometers off the coast of San Francisco, California, which opened on August 11th, 1934. The main prison building was actually built in 1910 to 1912, during the time when it was used as a United States Army prison for World War I. When the disciplinary barracks were acquired on October 1933 by the United States Department of Justice, the island then became a prison for the Federal Bureau of Prisons in August 1934. The buildings were upgraded to meet the requirements of a high-security prison, due to its such high security location, since it's, you know, 2 kilometers off the San Francisco Bay. It also, surrounds with cold water and strong currents. Alcatraz was believed to be escape proof. Now, seeing it was such a high security maximum prison thing, who would actually go there? Well, some of the worst of the times were actually in Alcatraz, because Alcatraz was designed so that prisoners that continuously caused trouble in their prisons were going to be sent to Alcatraz. Some of those people that were in Alcatraz were Al Capone, George the Machine Gun Kelly, Arthur R. Doc Barker, Alvin Creepy Caparis, who actually spent most of his time than any other prisoner in Alcatraz. Alcatraz gained its notability because of people's conceptions that it was the toughest prison in America. Former prisoners would often report acts of brutality and inhumane conditions. However, somewhat contradicting other prisoners that said Alcatraz's living conditions were much better than other prisons in the country, especially the food. On June 11th, 1962, Frank Morris, John Anglin, and Clarence Anglin, I think I'm saying that right, Anglin, A-N-G-L-I-N, once you pronounce that, carried out one of the most intricate escapes ever. Apparently, behind the prisoner's cell in cell block B, there was an unguarded 3-foot corridor. The prisoners were able to break away pieces of the moisture-damaged concrete from around the air vents using drills from things that they found around the prison. The escapees also made an inflatable raft from over 50 raincoats that they stole. They escaped through a vent in the roof and departed from Alcatraz Island. Nearby on Angel Island, the FBI found articles from the prisoners that were parts of rafts. The official FBI case said that since the water temperatures were about 50 to 55 degrees Fahrenheit, or 10 to 12 degrees Celsius, I think. It was about 2 kilometers or 1.25 miles, that there would barely be a chance of surviving, leaving the prisoners presumably dead. Now, okay, that was more of the exciting times of the prison. Let's move on to the final years, or the abandoned years. During the 1950s, Alcatraz became a very unpopular prison because it was far more expensive than any other prison institution in the United States. For an average prison jail in any other prison, it costed around $3 per prisoner a day, where in Alcatraz was around $10 a day per prisoner. Then director James V. Bennett, the director of Federal Bureau of Prisons, wanted to make more centralized institutions to replace Alcatraz. Other problems with Alcatraz included that the prison had seriously been damaged structurally from the exposure to the salt, air, and wind. It would have needed around $5 million to fix it. And actually, they started repairing the prison in 1958, but by 1961, engineers evaluated Alcatraz as a lost cause. Now, if you flash forward to today, Alcatraz is a museum and one of San Francisco's major tourist attractions, attracting more than 1.5 million visitors annually. Visitors get to have a tour of the cell house, cells, and pretty much mostly all the island, and are also given a slideshow to view, because why not? People who also visit Alcatraz say the atmosphere of the island is still very eerie and chilling. So technically, right now, Alcatraz is abandoned. That goes into this video, kind of. So even though it is a tourist attraction, it is abandoned. Like, they're not really doing any maintenance on it. So it is pretty cool that it does exist as a tourist attraction. And you're actually allowed to visit it. And it's also pretty good that they haven't destroyed it or, you know, anything. And it's pretty iconic, almost as iconic as the Golden Gate Bridge itself. As of right now, there's a pretty good chance that you know what Alcatraz is. I've only met, like, one person that doesn't know what Alcatraz is, because it's pretty famous. You're gonna find it a lot in media in itself. Like, for instance, I think it was called Alcatraz. It was with Sam Neill, the guy from Jurassic Park, and the fat guy from Lost. Remember that show? Yeah, that was a good show, kind of. I only watched, like, 5 episodes, and then it kind of got weird, because there was portals and doors and things. There was also the DLC for zombies on Black Ops, and that was a thing. That was fun. But, yeah, that's actually about it. Definitely go check out Alcatraz yourself. There's tons and tons and tons of videos on it on the internet. Go look at tours and all that. It's really fantastic. Go look at pictures on it, the pictures that you didn't see in this video. As always, my name is Jake. I thank you so much for watching Abandoned Episode 5. Leave what you want to see in the comment section below, because that's kind of important. Remember to like the video, you can like the video, but remember to like the comments in the video to show me what the majority wants. Do that, and it's gonna be splendid for episode 6. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Whatever you're doing today, make the most of it. I'll see you guys later. And outro! This is a quote. The institution severed important purpose. Oh my god! Alright. Try that again. The Bureau of Federal. Oh, fuck you. Alright.